What's happening, everybody? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with more TNT Evolution Map 8 Metal. And to get the first secret, all you have to do is just press on the wall to your left, and there it is. Now, this map, I do have to confess, and you probably already saw this coming, but I really don't like this map. And it's pretty much because of the fact that, I mean, it's unreasonably difficult. Especially, I mean, if you compare it to, like, the Nightmare difficulty, this map is probably one of the hardest ones to complete on that difficulty because of its design. And you're going to see that a lot when we progress in a sec here. So, yeah, just go in here, take out all the shotgunners. Now, let's go die, man, jeez. Let's go this way and get rid of this guy. Now, when you do, a whole bunch of more guys are gonna teleport in. And make sure that you kill that Spectre, because, you know, he might be a little hard to see in this annoyingly dark room. And here's another thing. When you walk up the steps, two chain gunners will open up. One right there, and one all the way the hell up there. And, I mean, that's just ridiculous. I mean, why is he so high up? You know? It's like, it's stupid. But anyway, this room is probably one of the... Yeah, this room is one of the many examples of why this map just sucks. Notice how such little cover there is from enemy fire. Notice how huge and just abnormally overscaled the room is. It's unreasonably large. And there's no reason why... I mean, I'm repeating myself here, but there's no reason why it should be this large. So anyway, come in here and press that switch. That is... I don't even know what that is. I think that's like the first secret. No, second secret. My bad. Yeah, that's right. First one was the chainsaw. Anyway, it lowers this over here. So then lower this down. And I just run in here, take down all the gunners. You know, same old shtick every map. Ugh. And then just get rid of these guys. Okay. Thought I heard you hissing at me. Alright. Will you just... God. Freaking hate this map. Alright. Oh, wow. That didn't even get you. Oh, hey, Spectres.
Yay.
Wow, there's a lot of them. Alright. Oh, more guys. Get the hell out of my face. Good God. No, stop. Alright, did anybody go back out here? Because sometimes they do, and it's really annoying when that happens. But anyway, to get the next secret, go down, or no, you press on that wall, and you get a supercharge. Which I guess is one good thing regarding health. Now, to get to this outdoor area, hear me out here. To get to this outdoor area, you have to open up this wall here, which, believe it or not, is a required secret. There's no reason why... And I hate to go on like a bitchy rant here, but there's no reason why secrets in a map should be required. There's no reason for it. Unless you're talking about like episode 2 map 9 of the Ultimate Doom, which, by the way, is small enough, and you know, you have to get it to exit the map. I mean, with this one, you just need to get out to here, and... It's just, it goes to show you just how lacking of a good design this is. I mean, it's stupid. I mean, I haven't said that already. But anyway, just press that switch to lower that wall so you can get back through. Now this final room, well not this next room, but the final room in this map, which is what we're coming up on, it's literally got to be the most... unoriginal, just boring looking, I don't know. Anyway, open this door up, fire, and then close the door again. Oh, whoops. Press that. I think all that does is just lower that. But anyway, what you want to do is come back here. Oh, whoops. No, I'm just going to jump and do that. I don't know. But anyway, come up here, and you'll have these two guys. Grab this partial invisibility, and with this, you want to keep this thing for as long as possible, because it's going to help out with this final area. go in here and just take out all the gunners. Well, pretty much, well, and imps. But see, like, it helps out with this part, that way they're not all shooting at you, which is a great strategy for, nightmare play. Alright, let's get... Are you oh my god. I so got that medikit and did not take damage. Come on now, that's just dumb. Map. I mean, look at how huge this map is. Pretty much the one thing that defines this freaking map is the huge rooms. I'm not joking. This is it's unacceptable. I'm just gonna go out and say it. Now, to get up there, what you have to do is press. Oh, get God no! I hate these goddamn lifts. But anyway, yeah. You have to freaking wait, and now you gotta re-lower it back down. But seriously, do yourself a favor. I should have made that. I should have made that just not even by jumping. And if, and the worst case scenario, I should have made that even with jumping. God. But anyway, that opens up this over here. Come on. Oh, that didn't even do anything. All right. Go, 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 go. No. Oh my god. See, you gotta wait for freaking ever. But seriously, do yourself a favor and don't miss these elevators. You'll save yourself so much time and pain of having to wait for these damn things. Oh, and of course I had to miss him. Die, man, jeez. So drop down, get rid of them two. Now get this, running into here will pretty much just take you up here. Which, I guess they tried to, like, make a trap, but they didn't really do a very good job with it. So yeah, that switch opens up this huge area in here. Now get this, press this and it'll raise that lift up, right? Now, you can wait for that, because it'll take you up there. But what happens when you come over here and press this? Oh, look, you can skip everything. There's... What is the point of all that? Seriously. Ugh. Anyway, just come up here. And we have yet more guys. So just deal with them as they come. Come over here, press that. And you get to... Whoa, no, get out of the poison. And then you get to come into the last area of this map. Which is pretty much just filled with Arachnotron, Shotgunners, and Imps. Alright, and then running to the exit door will open up the last group of guys. And that's it for Metal. Good lord. I seriously just don't know what freaking happened here. I mean, how does a map design like this even get counted? And this isn't even the worst of it, either. Like, we're talking... Like, if you thought this map was horrible, you haven't even seen, like, some of the later maps. Good lord, don't even get me started on those. But I'm just like, I sit here... I sat there playing this as I talked, and I just thought to myself... Who, in the right mind, designs a level like this? It's just... Every single one of these rooms... is pretty much made up of all these enemies, all like most of them hitscan enemies, that pretty much can just shoot at you from every which way, because there's no freaking room to hide from all of it. There's no cover. They're just oversized, big empty rooms. I mean, what kind of a map just has big empty rooms? I don't even know, but whatever, I can't even talk now. I seriously don't know how this map was even considered. I mean, I can sort of see how this one got considered. I mean, it's not the worst map in the game. Don't get me wrong. This one sucks majorly. But it's not the worst one. But still, how... I just don't know. I don't get it. I don't get why anyone would design a map with just big, bland rooms. It's like a kid... made this or something. And I hate to put it that bluntly, but still. But yeah, this map, if you play it on the nightmare difficulty, it is horribly difficult. But, and even more difficult than this one is the next map, which is Stronghold, map 9. But we'll get to that one when we get to it. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.